Hey everybody. Had pretty interesting lock got put into my hands at a party recently. My buddy Dave gave me this. It's a lock for the James Egan Company. Pretty sure that this was made by Slaymaker. I'm guessing maybe 100 years ago, somewhere in there. I haven't found a specific date on it, but I think probably around 1910-ish. Okay, so what makes this interesting is that the plug of the lock is actually connected directly to the shackle. What that means is the key will push forward, pushing the shackle back, and then it rotates. So you can't actually just get in here with a tension wrench and rotate. Now, to pick this, you can pull back on the shackle and pick, or try to push on the plug maybe, both of which are actually kind of difficult to do. Maybe if this were actually mounted on something, pulling wouldn't be so hard. But there's a much simpler way to attack this. It's a shimming attack. All you need for this is a DVD. Well, much more specifically, you need the security tag from the inside of a DVD, like so. So, pair of scissors. I'm just gonna clip the top of this off of here. And inside we will find two thin sheets of metal, which are being real jerks and don't know that I'm shooting a video and they're not coming out right now. Perfect. Okay, so with your thin bit of metal, we're just going to insert it above the keyway. So we're actually just going to tuck it back until we feel it touch the first pin in the lock. And then we go in with our pick, and we're slowly pushing this in while we lift up on that pin. And once we're at the shear line, this will slip right into place. And we just keep doing that, one pin after another after another. So we've got the first two there, I believe. I think this is only a four-pin lock. There we go, there's the third. And that was the fourth. Bam, okay. And now it has slid pretty deep in. So literally we're just going one pin after the next, after the next, after the next, and allowing this to slide in place, holding all of the drivers up, and this is at the shear line. Once we're there, we can pull backward and rotate out. And our lock is picked. So, push key locks, pretty neat, but very susceptible to a shimming attack. Normal locks aren't susceptible to a shimming attack because they have a lip around the edge here. But similarly, those locks you couldn't push in. So it's a necessary evil in a push key lock, but a really simple attack. So there you go. Neat lock. Very cool find. Thanks, Dave. Bye.